Good day, viewers. My name is Sharon Marime. Welcome to Lifewalk. Dream it, live it. This is the place where we make dreams come to life. We as Lifewalk believe that we can make the Zimbabwean film industry great again. Borrowed from Trump, not my words, but I believe that we can do it. And today on the show, we have a very, very, very important guest with us from the film industry. And welcome to the show, Mr. Leonard Chibhamu.
Okay, thank you very much,
okay.
Sharon.
Mr. Leonard, tell us about yourself.
Okay, I am a financial expert by profession, and of course, I am a film producer coming out of my passion and of course my love for the film industry in Zimbabwe.
Okay, you said you're a financial expert and also a film producer. How do those two coordinate? How do they come together?
It is a symbiotic relationship, like that of fish and water. Talking about film without talking of finance is a myth. A film is a function of several factors. One of the critical components of the film production is the aspect of finance. And by finance, you're talking of your financial strategies. Money is that which makes things start to happen.
Okay. I love the subject of money. You know, I love money. So tell the viewers out there.
Yes.
When you have money, you come up with a good production, or it's all about playing around with the money?
Thank you very much for such a very good question. What I can tell you is that talking about money, I'm talking of money in the sense of finance. By finance, I'm saying it's not about the physical cash that you have in your pocket, but by coming up with sound financial strategies that you employ particularly to service costs of a few. So basically, that is what I refer to as finance.
Okay. So you meaning to say, I do not necessarily need to have physical cash.
We are looking at both an assessment of the costs that are involved in the production of the film, as well as returns, expected returns. Like when you do produce a film, you'll be looking forward to get a profit, which sometimes people in financial terms, they call them returns. And of course, by returns, we are saying that positive aspect of money. When you get more, you invest like $10, tomorrow you get $12, that excess. So the reverse or the opposite can be a loss, which in financial terms, sometimes they call it risk. So basically, that is what I'm talking about.
Okay. It brings a whole new light to this whole financing thing. Now, I want to move on to the film part. You said you're a producer, you're a director, you're a writer, all in one. How do you manage to do that?
Definitely, it was something that I never wished to do. But of course, looking at our own Zimbabwean film industry, it is that industry where if you want to stay in the industry, you have to look for such financial strategies whereby you're trying to reduce the costs. Like in film production, we have got the upside of the costs. Some they call it below the line budget and up the line budget. So basically, there are certain costs that are involved that you cannot avoid. So by accumulating several roles in one person, you are trying to wipe away costs in order to sustain in the industry. So basically, maybe going back to your question, why am I doing this? Actually, when I got into the film industry, it was after I was, I'm from Chibu, that's where I was born. And of course, I grew up reading novels from Charles Mungoshi. So one of the days I said, no, Charles Mungoshi was famous because of his books. And even he put our area into spotlight through writing books. But in the modern society, people now want to watch it, possibly in form of movies. That's when I got into the industry. But obviously, getting into the industry, coming from the financial side, by then I was studying my first degree in banking and finance. So it was something difficult. But rather, I had to follow my passion, which was doing like film recording and so on. So I had to dig deep into it. But obviously, when I was doing it, a lot of people were asking me, how come you are doing banking and finance as a degree, but you are into film? How does that relate? Then obviously, in order to answer this, I had to do a research. The research which I conducted, I actually came out with a model of the film industry in Zimbabwe, where I noticed that finance is the critical component of the film production process in Zimbabwe. That which we cannot do. We can have best actors, we can have the best cameramen, we can have everything, but without money. Because money is that which we use to pay. So first, before, let's say a script is there, the first thing that you need to do is to come out with financial strategies that you can employ in order to service the costs which are associated with the film production.
Thank you very much. I'm glad you mentioned Charles Mungoshi.
Yes.
You know, even when we were growing up, we used to read a lot of his novels, and some of his novels were adopted into film.
Yes.
Now, my question is, the film industry in Zimbabwe, it has been on a downhill recession.
Yes.
If I should say, what are you bringing to the table? What is new? What is it that you're doing to bring the faith of the people back into the film industry in Zimbabwe?
Definitely, what I can assure you that the film industry of Zimbabwe can rise again. And if you can look at our neighbor in South Africa, the film industry is just good. If you go on to Nigeria, the film industry is just good. India, even if you can go to the USA, if you can talk of the Hollywood, everything is going on well. Just across the border in Zimbabwe, things are not well, which means there is something that we are not doing well. And of course, through some research, I've noticed that we are employing poor financial strategies. People are more interested in producing quality films, yet they don't know that the first thing that you need to talk about when you're talking of film is an investment into the aspect of financial management.
Financial management. So you're saying that as a production company, yes, you need to engage a financial expert.
Yes.
Is that not costly for these, below the bread level kind of producers and...
Okay. Normally, when we are talking in financial terms, we cannot only focus on costs, but rather we are looking at an establishment where we are making profit. So by making profit, which means your revenue has surpassed that of costs. So basically, costs are a factor to revenue that you get, and the excess that you get is that which pushes your agenda forward.
As a producer, as a big fish, if I should say, in this industry, what are you doing in order to conscientize, in order to educate other film producers out there about this low budget movies and other ways of making it happen without actually pumping out a lot of money?
Thank you for this platform. What I can tell you is that it's possible to produce even a high budget film in an environment like that in Zimbabwe. But obviously, I know my fellows who are good there, they are eager to know how they can make it. And obviously, like first you asked about what am I doing in order to conscientize people here. What I did is through research, I noticed that I should create an arts association. So what I did, I went to my rural home. You know, charity begins at home.
Yes.
So we established an association called Manyenechim Arts Association. And within the association, we took people from the society, even those people who had a poor, backgrounds, as well as low levels of education. And we have completely transformed those people to believe that film industry is the way to go and how they can survive in such an industry and how they can be economically viable. To the generality of Zimbabwe, it is quite difficult as an individual to make an impact, but rather the seed that I'm sowing to my fellows who are out there is that there is no way you can move forward in the film industry when you are not employing the techniques of financial management or financial engineering. Of course, I might sound too technical because I'm referring to deep financial, the financial language. But what I'm simply saying, there are people out there who are eager to partner you in your projects. But how they can come, of course, your vision might be good, but rather, possibly you're approaching a bank. The bank is more particular about risk of investing in a failing business. So they have no time to get to know what the film industry is like. But rather, what they need is they want to support you when you go and approach them and show that you are bankable. By being bankable, it's not about producing a bank statement that has got huge sums of money. But by being bankable, it's about someone who is ethical, who has got a good, sound financial, in form of documents or whatever. So that is very important. So by approaching a bank, possibly you'll be looking for a loan. So what they're interested in is that, are you able to service the loan? By servicing, which means you have to present them with a cash flow statement, which actually stipulates what is it that you expect, like in form of revenue, and for how long are you going to be accumulating revenue streams. At the same time, are they able to service the cost? And the cost of servicing loan is that of repayment of the loan and the interest. So that is what they are interested in. And of course, by the aspect of risk, risk is also a critical component, especially in the financial side. So, like in our film industry in Zimbabwe, it's difficult for you to ask a producer to come up with a quantification of risk. Risk, the amount of risk is very important, especially when you are doing a project. So that a bank, when it comes to finance your project, they want to hedge. By hedging, which means they want to invest money into different portfolios, which, like when the other one is not performing, the other one is performing. So they want to try to eliminate risk. So basically, that is what is needed. Sometimes people throw in, you know, proposals, good proposal in terms of their synopsis, good, you know, in terms of those documents, a good script, but that doesn't matter to someone who is investing. They are interested in money, the money side. So you need to employ a financial strategist, someone who has got a sound background. So rather, it's difficult for us to maybe find people who have got a sound background about the film industry. But rather, we should start moving to think critically along that area. I think that is my advice to my fellows who are out there.
There you have it. It's all about strategy. Are you bankable?
Makutomuka zvenyu vasikati. Futi ka makagarika ini. Kutanga nekutora pension aini basa ndoridawo iyi.
Before we went for the break, you spoke about your productions. I understand you have three productions which are out so far. Tell the viewers out there about those productions.
Okay, currently I can boast of three productions which I did, which was of course a film sequel. It was, some they call it a series of three. So the first one, it came out in 2018, the other one 2014, and the other one 2016. So the title of the film is So It Was Said. It was series 1, series 2, series 3. And of course, beyond it, I've got the other film called The Village Secrets that is in post-production. And I'm expecting also to shoot another film called I'm a Model. And of course, you see that in my first production, I was shooting in the rural. And I'm also moving to the urban, where I'm going to shoot a film called I'm a Model. That film, I was actually inspired by the Zimbabwean model industry. I was at one time involved in the photography of models. So there was that myth that the community holds about models. So I decided to write a story which exposes what happens in the industry. But I think that is a topic.
Take us through the process of these productions, the three which are out already. You said you had a rural setting. Tell me about that experience.
Actually, it was naturally good to me because I grew up in the rural area in Chibhamu, in Maronda Mashan to be particular. And you know, when I grew up, there were certain stories which were happening, and there were certain places which we used to frequent, you know, see. So going there, shooting a film, it was something that was a dream come true. And I wanted to tell a Zimbabwean story in my own rural setting, and of course being proud to be being associated with my rural community.
Okay, thank you. We also hear about the great things that you're doing in that place, the place of Chibhamu. You're not only shooting, but yes, you're employing people. Tell the viewers out there about growing up in the rural areas, and there comes someone with a vision.
Okay. As someone who grew up in the rural area, and of course now I'm staying in the capital, Harare, which means I'm someone who can link the two lives. And obviously, I'm someone who can see opportunities existing in the rural and also in the urban. And of course, this opportunity coming in the form of film, and that's why I took it to my rural community, Manyene. And obviously, I've got a very big ambition, and that is possibly to try to change the complexion of the Zimbabwean film industry through creating or cultivating a good, a positive culture in the industry where people can believe that this same industry can be big again.
Wow, that is amazing. So you seem to have a very active life. You seem to lead a very active life. You're a busy man. How do you juggle that with your family life?
Obviously, you know, life you live once. So sometimes life is too short. So you try to make sure that whenever you get the slightest opportunity, you try to make value out of time. You know, people say time is money. So like when you are still young, energetic, you have to try to juggle, make time for everything. And obviously there's time to make funny, time for productions, time for everything.
What do you have to say to that little girl, that little boy, that old man, that old woman, that middle-aged person out there about pursuing their dreams?
If you want to invest within a year, plant maize. If you want to invest for 10 years, plant trees. But if you want to invest for 100 years, then educate a generation. This is my message. It's never too late to change one's dream.
In a nutshell, all he's saying is that the world is changing and you have to change it with you. Leaving it, I know that I can be something else. And you too can be something else. You can live your life to the fullest. And I'd like to thank you very much for this very insightful interview. We're hoping to have you again, hopefully soon.
Okay.
For another interview when we'll be talking other things, because I know we did not quite cover everything.
Okay.
So thank you very much for coming to our show. And this is me saying you can be all that you set your mind to be. Dream big, live it, signing out.